All right, the traders are answering your questions. First up for Joe, this is Bob from Utah. He asks, is Dominion Energy a buy, sell, or hold? What do you say, Joe?
I would call Dominion Energy a hold. This is an integrated utility. I'm not that excited about it. I understand Warren Buffett was. It's given a little bit life to midstream MLPs. There is some election risk. I would say if you want to allocate towards energy, I want to go to the diversified integrated names. I own Chevron.
All right. This next one is for Jim. Lindy from Weston wants to know, is Greenbrier still a buy in this economy? Jim, what do you tell? What do you tell her?
Yeah. So, Lindy, I do think it is a buy. You said in this economy. This economy right now is a recession. So it's not like you look at Greenbrier and say, oh, great, I want to own a rail car manufacturer. The thing is you got to look past the canyon. You got to look a year, 2 years from now when the economy is humming along. You know, 3 years ago, this stock was earning almost $6 a share. With the strategic acquisitions they've made in the past couple of years, I think they'll be back there and beyond in the coming years. So you just got to stick through the canyon here. It's a long-term investment.
All right. For Weiss, any thoughts on Fastly or Cloudera? Which is the better bet? That is from Mario in Illinois. Steve.
First of all, Mario, thank you, unlike Mel, for giving me something positive to talk about. Cloudera, that's the one that I own. You've got two prongs here. The first is that they're turning around the company and it's in the cloud space, as the name implies. Second, if you've got a large shareholder who I believe is working to sell the company, and that's Carl Icahn. So I'm still in Cloudera. I had exited. I came back into it a couple of months ago. I'd play that one.
Unlike Mel, who doesn't give you anything. You get what you get, Steve. That's the way it goes. That's the way the cookie crumbles. All right, this one's up from Art in Chicago for Liz. Small cap value has taken a big hit this year. Should I rebalance my 401k and move it to large cap growth at this juncture? Liz?
I love a question about small cap, but here's the problem, Art. The biggest sector in small cap value is financials at 22%. I like the small cap space because it leads us out of recessions, but I think you should rotate into small cap growth, where the biggest sector is surprisingly not IT, but healthcare at 32%, and that exposure should do you well.
That's interesting. All right, we've got time for another round. We'll hit it. Here's one from Peter in Ohio. How do you feel about insurance stocks in general and Cincinnati Financial in particular, Jim?
Okay, so Cincinnati Financial, Liz will like this. That's a small cap. It's more property and casualty. I like the name. Probably a high teens multiple. I'd rather go Progressive PGR, which I've talked about frequently. That's personal and commercial automobiles. I like that insurance exposure better.
Okay, this one's for Jim. Alex in Canada wants to know if Pfizer here is a buy. What do you say?
Hey, Alex, good question, and yes, it is. Look, about a month ago, stock got knocked down when its Ibrance cancer drug failed a trial. But that's set up for this month. We see that it's last week, it's got a real lead contender in the vaccine race on COVID. I think at this price and a 4.5% dividend yield, it's a great buy. You just have to make sure you don't think this is Moderna or Inovia or something like that. It's never going to run like that. It's a safe bet, though.
All right. Lastly, here's a question for Liz. This is from Jules in Montreal. It feels like the market is back to January, February sentiment, which was overpriced. I'm 90% equities, 10% cash. Should I be selling to buy bonds or commodities to hedge? Liz, what do you say?
If we have another sell-off like we saw in March, I think the behavior would be the same and investors would want to raise dollars, which means they're going to sell things like gold, they're going to sell things like bonds. So in order to hedge, what you want to use is multi-alternative strategies and things that have the flexibility to use put options, which would protect from some of those really steep drawdowns.